Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Alleluia. It is Easter morning, the first day of the week, and it's the holiest and most central day on the entire Christian calendar, which means the long Lenten and Paschal fast is finally over. The church is clothed in white, having been purified by penance both from within and from without this Lenten season. And now our hearts are filled with the joy of faith that is reborn in all of its newness. Easter, frankly, is not so much a day as it is a choice, or maybe a way of life. It's a vision, and it's an outlook rooted in a historical truth, namely that the most heinous and powerful act of evil and darkness ever committed, the rejection and death of God himself, was overcome by an even stronger act of pure goodness and love and a pure gift of recreative power when God destroyed death by raising up his only son. Think of where we'd be today if there had been no resurrection. Jesus would surely have been forgotten. There would be no church, no New Testament, no sacraments, no saints. Never mind what that would have meant for the development of Christian Europe and Western civilization. It wouldn't have happened, quite frankly. But beyond that, it would mean that all the darkness and hardship in life would hold us in its bondage because there would be no hope for anything stronger. Reality would simply be no greater than whatever we see or experience at first glance. Easter is not just a day and not just the event. It's the reality and knowledge that all hardship, all suffering can be transformed because we know that there is another layer to life, both now and beyond. There is another layer to be seen. I realize that the choice to believe in Easter can be tough, that the vision and joy and optimism of Easter can be elusive. In the past year, we've had our share of hardships, haven't we, that make Easter kind of hard to believe in sometimes, hard to choose, you might say. I'm sure you all know someone who has had cancer or has died or has perhaps been killed, who's been seriously sick. We've all been watching the American political scene grow to new levels of nastiness and even godlessness that are quite disturbing. And there continues to be a great deal of fear and hardship over the economy, with many of you still being out of work. That's a challenge. The parishes in West Bend have been through personnel changes that have had to make us all, including me, rethink what is the familiar in our parish life. And our parishes and schools have had their share of arguments of late about many things. And of course, there is the continuing shadow of the abuse scandals in the church that seem to follow us every day in the papers. So there's enough out there to hem us in, isn't there? There's a lot to make us question Easter and not to choose it, not to believe it, not to see as the resurrected Lord would have us see. But consider this truth. The church has celebrated Easter around the world every year without fail for centuries, and often in some very dark times and places, darker than these. Imagine what it must have been like, for example, celebrating Holy Week in those years when the Muslim invaders took Jerusalem and took control of the holy shrines and places there, the sepulcher, Bethlehem. The Christian church throughout the world, they thought that the church in the world was ending, both there and in Europe. Easter was a real challenge then, but they had no choice to believe in it, and so they did. Or the time of the Black Plague, when thousands and thousands of men and women and children, rich and poor alike, were getting killed off all over Europe, in what seemed like a relentless onslaught of deaths destroying power. Easter had a profound meaning for them then, and again, they had no choice but to believe in it, so they did. Or 5 years ago, when the entire world watched Venerable John Paul the Great dying right during Easter, even the unbelievers believed in Easter then because no one would claim that that man would not go on to something greater after this life. Or 2,000 years ago, when only days earlier the disciples had witnessed the brutal, humiliating public death of their leader Jesus, in whom they had placed so much hope and so much promise. And to come back to the tomb was to come within a stone's throw of that very spot of death and relive that horror all over again. That was a dark time, to be sure. But it was then, in their grief, that they discovered the peace that up until then they couldn't have grasped, but the way they were missing all along. The fact that Jesus was able to overcome even death. He was gone. The tomb was empty. He had risen. He had risen. This forced the disciples to adopt a new vision, to choose, to see things differently. It turned their gaze upward and outward. Now, the only thing that could make all that they knew make any sense at all, the key to unlocking all of reality, to decoding existence, was one thing. It was the resurrection. They saw all of life through it. All of life, all of creation, is now subject to the dominion of God. He reigns and rules even over death. Even death's seemingly unstoppable power has now been compromised, which is a bold and daring thing for us to believe and consider. If Jesus was raised, then nothing could take him from them or us ever again. If Jesus was raised, then the sufferings and hardships and questions of this life were no longer the final answer. Faith is now deeper. Faith has new boldness. Faith can actually be the answer rather than the question. Which means that for us now, in all the challenging events of life, all the hardship, all the suffering, whatever it is we face this year or whenever, we can still believe and have hope precisely because he is risen. And we can see the world through the lens of Easter, and we can trust that underneath the surface of everything visible, a deeper reality glows through. The reality of a world graced by Christ's death and resurrection. This is how it was for Peter and John and the others. They came to see what the empty tomb really meant, and their vision was suddenly broadened, and the past, present, and future were all seen in a brand new light. This is how, through all the worst conflicts and challenges of history, the church can forge ahead, because we can see behind and beyond the sufferings of the moment. The resurrection leads us forward through time, always. This is how we're able to see that this is not bread and wine on the altar, but is actually the risen presence of Christ. How we can see that the ordinary water over here actually washes away sin, that it cleanses us on the inside and not just the outside. This is how we can see that it's not simply olive oil that we rub onto people in our sacraments, but it's actually the presence of the Holy Spirit filling them as in a temple. Without Easter, none of this is possible. Our vision remains limited, and the broken world holds the limits of all of our belief. But Easter makes it all new. It makes authentic life possible. So we are nothing. We are nothing without faith, without Mass every single Sunday, without gathering each week on the first day of the week, on the day that Jesus rose, so that each week the resurrection can redefine our vision once again. Without Sunday, then Easter cannot be a way of life. It's simply an afterthought and an empty dogma that doesn't shape us or define us at all. So Sunday is a choice. Easter is a choice. Yes, Sunday is everything because Easter really is everything. It's not just a day, it's a new way of seeing, and it is a way of life. A blessed Easter to all of you.